This week, let's take a look at the right-hand probe, because last week we had a look at the left-hand probe. So a right-hand probe, as I said before, the chamfer is on the right and your functional edge is on the left. So one thing to note is if you bring up a watch variable window and type in GB underscore FE 0, a right-hand probe will always show a zero value and not the probe thickness like the left hand, because the functional edge is on the left, and this is automatically taken care during the probe qualification. If you enter as a right hand probe, it knows that it's where the functional edge is, and the probe thickness becomes zero automatically. Now, a lot of people use the right hand probe during cool and hold digitizing, because on the right hand probe, because the edge is actually on the left, and when you tilt the C-axis, it's very easy to get into a cool and hold with the right hand probe. So you can go and digitize cool and holds as small as 0.2, 0.25 quite easily with the right hand probe. What happens with the left hand probe is, because the chamfer is on this side, on the left side, and when you try to digitize the cool and hold, this actually fouls with the edge, and you sometimes, you know, struggle to get in into a cool and hold. But if the cool and hold diameter is slightly bigger, about 0.5 or above, you could probably use the left hand probe as well. But generally, a right hand probe is used to pick up a small diameter cool and holds, less than 0.5, maybe 0.5 millimeter. Next week, we'll take you through what a double edge probe does and where we use a double edge probe.